This video introduces request fulfillment in Service Catalog via execution plans or workflows. Linked timecodes for these topics appear in the YouTube description for this video. With the Service Catalog application, you can create one or multiple catalogs of products and shared services that your organization offers to its employees, customers, suppliers, and others. When someone orders an item or requests a service from a catalog, various people and groups in your organization perform a series of activities to fulfill the request. These people, groups, and activities are specified in an execution plan or a workflow. By selecting an execution plan or workflow in a catalog item or record producer, you define the request fulfillment for the item. So what's the difference between execution plans and workflows? Execution plans enable you to define simple, linear processes consisting of a set of tasks. Each task specifies the activities and people who perform the task. Here's an example of an execution plan for delivering a corporate standard PC. First, a user submits a new request in the service catalog and a manager approves it. Second, the procurement department obtains the computer from a supplier. Next, the IT software team configures the standard software on the computer. And finally, the IT hardware team installs the computer at the employee's desk. But most fulfillment processes are more complicated or need more flexibility. That's where workflows come in. Let's take a look at this workflow in the base system for service catalog item requests. It provides a complex, non-linear set of processes that provides contingencies and notifications when an item is backordered or an approval at any stage is rejected or approved. The workflow editor provides a large selection of activities, in addition to tasks, that you can use to build your workflow. Now let's look at creating an execution plan. In our example, we want an execution plan for ergonomic furniture requests. Employees must provide a doctor's recommendation to be eligible for ergonomic office furniture. We want this plan to include an approval task requiring the requester's manager to verify that the employee provided the recommendation. Keep in mind that only administrators and catalog administrators can create execution plans. We start by navigating to Service Catalog, Catalog Administration, Execution Plans. The base system provides a number of execution plans that you can copy and customize for your own fulfillment request processes. But for our example, let's create a new execution plan. Here we enter the name of the plan, Ergonomic Furniture Delivery Plan, and a short description for the plan. The delivery time is based on our normal work hours, Monday through Friday, 9 to 5. The total delivery time is calculated automatically from the delivery times of the individual tasks. After adding the execution plan, we open the record to add tasks. We add a new approval task first. In our example, we want the employee's manager to approve the request before any actions are taken. Let's leave the order value at 100. We'll give later tasks higher order values so that they come after this task. In delivery time, we indicate how much time is allotted for this task. In this case, 2 days. We provide a short description of the task, as well as specific instructions to the approver. And we select the action that is taken upon approval or rejection of the task. Note that if you choose to go to a previous task, you need to select the task that the plan will execute. In our example, we leave these as is and submit the task. Now we need to define the approver for this task, a group or an individual approver. But in this case, the approver is the requester's manager, so the value is dynamic. We need to add a script to find this value for us in the approval script field. After updating the record, we add our next task, an execution plan task. After the approval, we need our procurement team to order the item, so we select that as our fulfillment group here. We set the order to 200, so it will run after the approval task we just added. We expect the item to be ordered in 1 day, which we specify in delivery time. We enter a short description of the task, as well as any instructions for the task fulfiller, and submit the task. We continue to add tasks until our execution plan is complete. But what if we needed a more complex process to fulfill this request? The base system provides some workflows that you can copy and customize for your own requirements. Or you can create a new workflow. For our example, let's create a simple workflow in the workflow editor to see the basics of setting one up. For service catalog workflows, we select the requested item table, so the workflow will fulfill the request of a single catalog item. After we submit the form, we add activities to the workflow to perform tasks such as running scripts, sending notifications, or requesting approvals. Let's start by setting up an approval. We set the stage to waiting for approval. Next, we select an approver. We want the requester's manager to approve the request, so we unlock the users list to edit it. The user's manager is in a related table, so we click Select Fields, Request, Requested for, Manager. So we selected the manager of the person that the item is requested for. Finally, we submit the task. Now we need to route the workflow depending on whether the approver approves or rejects the request. First, we create a set value activity to end the workflow if the request is rejected. In this case, we set the workflow stage to completed, mark the approval as rejected, and then end the workflow by connecting the approval activity, the rejected value, and the end of the workflow with transitions. Next, we create another set value activity to move the request to the fulfillment stage if it's approved. We set the workflow stage to fulfillment, set the value of approval to approved, and connect the approval activity to the approved value. We can also delete the transition between the approval and the end of the workflow here. Now let's create the next task in the workflow, procuring the requested furniture item. The catalog task activity creates a service catalog task record. Here we set the task priority. We also need to select a fulfillment group to order the item. With the task added to the workflow, we connect the approval to the task with a transition. Now let's set up a notification to let the requester know that the item has been received. In the addressees section, we define who receives the notification. The requester is in a related table, so we click Select Fields, Request, Requested for. So we select the person that the item is requested for. Finally, we add the notification message. You can add variables here to customize the message. Now we add the final catalog task in our workflow. The field services team delivers the item to the requester. Finally, we add a log message before the end of the workflow, which leaves a message in the log indicating that the workflow completed successfully. You can also use log messages in a workflow for debugging. Before deploying a workflow in Service Catalog, ensure that all of the activities on the workflow are connected, and delete the transition between the begin and end activities if you haven't already. Now we validate the workflow, which shows any issues. Everything looks good here, so we're ready to publish the workflow to make it available to all users. For more information, please consult our product documentation, knowledge base, or podcast, or ask a question in the ServiceNow community. For cost-effective training solutions, contact ServiceNow Education Services.